Coral are a fundamental ecosystem in our oceans. We really need to save them. They're really critical for life on Earth. My name is Mary HAGEDORN, and I work on coral conservation and preservation. We've been applying human reproductive techniques like freezing sperm to coral, and it allows you to preserve those cells for a year or hundreds of years. We are going to thaw sperm that's been in our banks for over 10 years and use them on fresh Curaçao eggs to create embryos that wouldn't occur normally in the wild. For this particular species of coral, which is elkhorn coral, there's a western population, which is like Florida. There's a mixed population. And then there's an eastern population, which is here in Curaçao.
If the corals do fertilize, then we have a whole new tool for coral restoration, which is the ability to bring different genotypes from one region to another.
And that's what the goal is here, is to help diversify the population and to give us cues as to whether those newly made, newly created reproductive organisms are going to be better at adapting for the future.
Around the Caribbean, we've lost something like 98% of this coral species. And in Florida, it's even worse than that because we're finding that there aren't very many genetically distinct individuals. They're one of the most important species in the Caribbean because of the structure and the shape they make. Also because they protect shorelines from waves, they create habitat for fish to hide underneath, and they're also powerful species because when they do break apart, they can attach back to the reef and make more colonies. This species has bundles of eggs mixed with sperm, and it holds them in its mouth, and then we know in the next 10 or 20 or 30 minutes that they're going to release them all at the same time. We have all sorts of nets and contraptions that we use to collect the eggs once they're released from the colony. Then we have to get back to shore.
That gets transported into the laboratory. We'll clean the eggs very well, and then we'll begin adding sperm.
And if it all goes great, the eggs go from 1 to 2 to 4 cells and start dividing and forming the larva.
We will put them into water bottles and we'll transport them to Miami. And our partners, Florida Aquarium and MOTE Marine Lab, will meet us there.
Our coral babies!
And they'll begin the process of settling those larvae.
This is it. Here's all of our coral babies. They're all doing fantastic. I was super scared when I first got these things that they were going to be so totally different that they wouldn't work out. But thankfully, I was wrong. They're extremely healthy. They're growing extremely rapidly.
We couldn't ask for a better result than what we're seeing right here. This is amazing. It really is.
Calling that a win.
Absolutely.
There's a lot of work that went into these little guys.
Yeah. To get to this place today, it's taken us 15 years. It's super important that we make really robust banks to conserve the genetics in as good a state as we can. This not only can work, but it can work in the kind of numbers that can be an assistance for restoration.